students, today we will see step response of series RC circuit. The objective of this experiment is to study charging and discharging of capacitor through resistor for application of DC voltage, that is transient response of RC series circuit. So let's start. So we will need LTSpice software. Here we have LTSpice software. I have already opened this window, so we know this is the main window. Next, go to file, new schematic, and save this schematic as experiment name. Go to file, save as EXP RC step. Save. So for this experiment we will need only three components: a voltage source, a resistor and a capacitor. Go to components, type voltage, put here. Next, take one resistor R1, R, press escape. Take one capacitor, this is capacitor, press escape, and connect all the elements. Also we need ground here, so connect ground in this circuit. Now we will put values for voltage source. So for observing charging and discharging of capacitor, we need a pulse type source or square type source. So right click on this source, go to advanced, here we have pulse. Pulse source will give a square type source. So after selecting pulse we will save these values. So we will save this one by one. Initial voltage is 0 volt, then V on means magnitude of the voltage is 10 volt, then time delay we will put this at 0. Rise time for square wave is 1 nanosecond, fall time is also same, 1 nanosecond. Then T on means time period for the square wave pop. Let's put this as 10 millisecond, and T period, total period of this square wave pop is 20 millisecond. So it will remain on for 10 millisecond and off for 10 millisecond. And number of cycles we will take 2. Okay. So remember these values: T period is 20 millisecond, number of cycle is 2. So according to this, we have to set stop time for the simulations. Okay. This is now done. Let's put value for resistance R1. So we will take R1 as 1 ohm. Okay, then C capacitor, we have to select this in microfarad, so put 1 micro first, 1 mu, so put 1 U, you can see here 1 micro, we will just modify this, we will take resistance as 1 kilo, K, because we know that for this RC circuit, the time constant is tau is equal to RC. So multiplication of this 1 micro into 1 kilo results in 1 milli. So 1 millisecond will be the time constant for this circuit. We have to observe this time constant for the circuit while charging the capacitor. Next step is put simulation parameters. stop time is 20 millisecond into 2 is 40 millisecond, it's 0. Maximum step time is 0.01. Okay, done. Everything is done. So we'll try to simulate. What we have to observe? We have to observe the voltage across capacitor and the source voltage. Okay, initially we will observe source voltage and then capacitor voltage. Run. So after running we will get one window which will see, which will show us a graph for the voltage. So let's go to here, node V1. So see this here, this is the square wave of square input to the network. This is 10 volt constant, then 0 volt for 20 millisecond. Again same is repeating. So for observing charging and discharging, we will click here, capacitor voltage, click here. So you can see that blue stress is for capacitor voltage. So we can change the color of this stress to the red. Let's do this. So see this now it is. So when the source is on, capacitor is charging, and when the source is off, it is discharging. Okay. So we have observed this charging and discharging of the capacitor. Next we have to observe time constant of the circuit. So already we have calculated time constant as 1k into 1 mu. 1k into 1 mu is 1 millisecond. So let's modify simulation time to 10 millisecond. Sorry, 20 millisecond. Let's check charging time, 10 millisecond. Okay, and again run this simulation. So you can see here, for 10 millisecond, 0 to 10 millisecond, capacitor is charging. And we have to observe the value for 1 millisecond. So as per the definition of time constant of RC circuit, it is defined as, the time constant is defined as the time required to charge the capacitor up to its 0.632 steady state value. So steady state value here is 10 volt. 10 volt into 0.632 is almost 6.3 volt. So we will observe the voltage at 1 millisecond. So this is 1 millisecond time period, and go to here. So you can see here, for 1 millisecond we are getting 6.25 volt. For 1 millisecond we are getting 6.25 volt. So as per definition it should be 6.32 volt. So we will observe the time required for this 6.32 volt. So let's drag this cursor further. So after dragging we can observe here, for 6.33 volt we are getting time as 1.02 millisecond. So ideally the time constant of this circuit is 1 millisecond, but observe time period is, or time constant is 1 millisecond. So we have to put these values into observation table. Time constant calculated and time constant observed. So in next step you can change the values of these RC elements, then source voltage value, and can observe the time constants for various parameters. Okay, so the conclusion of this experiment is that time constant for charging of capacitor is same as that calculated. See, tau c was 1 millisecond and observed was 1.02, so it's almost equal. Okay, that's all for today's session.